at a premier management institute. A prospective employer says to the B school student, in this job, we need somebody responsible. How responsible are you? The almost MBA graduate says without even batting an eyelid, sir, I'm the one you should hire for this job. You see, whenever there's some trouble in my management institute and something goes wrong, they say I am responsible. So I'm responsible all the time. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a glittering evening where I assure you there are none such prospective MBAs. At least I hope not. The first ever City Grandmasters, ED City Grandmasters final. India's first and only national B-School challenge. It's time, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce you to our chief guest for the evening, the Honorable Minister for Higher and Technical Education, Medical Education and Energy in the Government of Maharashtra. Thank you, Honorable Minister, sir, for taking the time to come and spend this evening with us. I now call upon Shri Dilip Valse Patil Sahib to come and address us.
Good evening to everybody. I am indeed delighted to be here in your midst for Economic Times City Grand Masters Finale. This is really, it is a unique initiative to offer a platform for participants to give case study presentations. I am aware it is not a regular quiz where knowledge is tested, but this is more than that. My best wishes to all of you, and I declare this event open. Thank you.
Moving on with our flow of events for this special evening, it's time to say hello to our special invitee this evening. Theatre guru, ad man extraordinaire, and also a world-renowned consultant, Alec Padamsi is a leader amongst leaders. And so we'd like you to come on stage and say a few words.
Good evening, friends. This evening I have some good news for you, and I have some bad news for you. So what's the good news and the bad news today? I'll tell you. The bad news for all you students, the bad news is that computers are taking over thinking in the world. That's the bad news. What's the good news? The good news is that I think quizzes like this one are keeping our brains alive and ticking. And I really think that quizzes are a wonderful way of bringing edutainment to all of us. So put on your thinking caps. Don't just put your hands together, but put your brain together and go for it. Thank you.
Brace yourselves, because just in a few moments from now, ladies and gentlemen, the ETCD Grandmasters quiz is about to explode onto the stage. Yes, please welcome finalists number 1 and 2 at the ETCD Grandmasters, India's first ever National B-School Challenge. The team from IIFT, Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, Delhi, Pratik Sanghi and Vikas Upadhyay. Say hello to team number 2 from Sailesh J. Mehta School of Management, IIT Bombay, Prashant Sampath and Sandeep Matthew Olikal. Team number 3, ladies and gentlemen, here are our third zonal winners, the team from IMT Ghaziabad. Put your hands together. Represented by Harkirat Singh and Mukund Srivastav, the zonal winners from the Garden City are Monica and Nithin Kundra from IIM Bangalore. Team number 5, IIM Calcutta. It's Arnav Sinha and Vijay Anand Menon. Can it be enough to introduce the lions without introducing the ringmaster? Asia's biggest and best quizmaster, host of the Brand Equity Quiz, and quizmaster of the only Bonvita, one and only Bonvita quiz contest, the longest running quiz ever on Indian television. He is Penguin India's largest selling reference author, the ultimate legend of quizzing. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the quizmaster on the first ever ETCD Grandmasters Challenge, the one and only Derek O'Brien.
Actually, I'm feeling very nostalgic this evening when I was sitting backstage, and I'll tell you why. 16 years ago, almost to the day, or almost to the week certainly, the Economic Times asked me to give birth to a baby along with them, and the ET brand equity quiz was held exactly 16 years ago, and now I think 460 or 470 corporates take part. So today, good luck to the ET and City Jugalbandi. We've got five teams here on stage. Okay, so here we go. Good luck. We're going to start with a round where we give 5 points for your own subject because they've chosen some subjects and 10 points for a bonus. Okay, this is how it works. I've already told the teams this. So who do we go with? IIFT? So here we go. You guys chose a subject called finance or banking. So is that okay? Good. So here we go. Which term was originally used in its financial sense in the late 1600s in reference to the counterfoil of a draft that was used to prevent forgery and alterations? I want a six-letter answer. IIFT, no minus points. Five if you're right and 10 if you're wrong. No, IIM Bangalore, are you trying? Six-letter answer. No, IIM Calcutta. No six-letter answer, IIT Bombay.
Is it check?
Check is six-letter, C-H-E-Q-U-E. Too cool. 10 points. IIT Bombay. Check. IIM Bangalore, just tell me what you chose. Finance? Banking. Okay, here we go. The first American commemorative coin was produced in 1892 and it featured a famous explorer. Give me the name of the person. Are you guys trying? IIM Bangalore, not trying. We've got to be moving faster. IIM Calcutta.
Columbus.
Christopher Columbus. Who else could it be? IIM Calcutta. Well done, Christopher Columbus. IIM Calcutta, what subject are you going for? Outsourcing. So the concept of outsourcing started with which US presidential candidate when he founded Electronic Data Systems in 1962? Clue. Five-letter surname.
Ross Perot.
Ross Perot will get you 5 points. Good start. IIT Bombay, the next one's for you. IIT Bombay. In an outsourcing company, what is the concept of hoteling? Hoteling. This is in terms of office seating arrangements. Hoteling.
Okay. The funda is
the funda is. Okay, I got that. Okay.
The rooms funda. In the first floor start at 1. The second floor starts at 2. A similar kind of concept would be in outsourcing company, as in it's multi.
The rooms on the first floor start with 2.
1. And the second floor starts at 2, the cubicle number or...
To do with seating arrangements?
Yeah,
I mean... Hoteling, no. IIMT Ghaziabad? In an outsourcing company, to do with seating arrangements, what's the concept of hoteling?
Basically, everybody's sitting...
Basically, see? Okay.
They sit in facing rows, like, continuously one after another.
They sit in facing rows, continuously one after the other. Okay. IIFT? No.
People come and sit on whatever seat is free.
Absolutely cool. It's free seating. Hoteling is free seating. Very good. And IIMT Ghaziabad, the last one is for you. Here it is. Auto. Which car became the best-selling single design in history and was the first to reach sales of 20 million? The first car. Give me the brand.
Volkswagen Beetle.
Volkswagen Beetle. Unfortunately, is the most obvious answer, and sometimes when you go for the obvious answer, you're invariably correct. It is the Volkswagen Beetle. 5 points to you. Very, very good. Our second round, here we go. This one we call opening move. Teams, in this, your opening move. We're going to give you a question with three options. Get it right the first time, 15. If you still don't get it right, then hazard a guess for 5, okay? We start with IIMT. The first one is for you. Peter Drucker said, the purpose of a business is to create a customer, relationship, or to create a profit. 15 or 5. So first time, make your opening move. IIMT, little bit of a discussion. Quick.
Profit.
Profit. Yeah, that's a good... Do you think he's right? Anyway, let's see. Red means your intentions were very bad, huh? To create a profit. Okay, see, City, nice guys. See, ET, nice guys. No profit. Okay, it's either customer or relationship.
A customer.
I hope it's green for 5. Very good. It is green for 5. Okay. Good. That's the opening move. Now, IIT, we've got one for you. Okay. IIT, which concept did Maki Kaji create? Your choices are Kanban, Sudoku, or Kaizen.
Okay, we'll go with Kanban.
You go with?
Kanban.
Kanban. Yeah, that sounds like the correct answer. And invariably it's wrong. So, Sudoku or Kaizen?
Sudoku.
Sudoku for 5. If you're right, I hope it becomes green. Sudoku, good. IIT, he's the man behind Sudoku. Okay, lovely. The next one is for IIM. ISO 7816 is the international standard for smart cards, condoms, or currencies?
Smart cards.
IIM, you don't have to give such serious answers. Very good, 15. Okay. IIM Bangalore, this one's for you. According to Mahatma Gandhi, the study of Indian economics is the study of the farmers, the spinning wheel, or the Bhagavad Gita. Are you guys trying?
Farmers.
IIM?
Farmers.
Farmers.
Okay. Spinning wheel.
Mm-hmm.
Spinning wheel.
Spinning wheel. That sounds like the right answer. Yes, 5 points. Well done. Well done. IIFT, the last ones for you. In the 1960s, by what name did the brand called Canadian Lady become well known? Victoria's Secret, Maybelline, Wonderbra. Started in the US and then moved to Canada and then across the world. One of these brands. So, here's a question on brands. Are you guys trying?
Victoria's Secret.
You're almost feeling shy to say the answer, but anyway. Victoria's Secret. Okay.
Wonderbra.
Oh, you were very quick on the second one. Yeah, 5. Excellent.
The Economic Times City Grandmasters. The mutual fund industry is booming, but who are the real shining stars? Witness as we recognize and reward the top funds of the year. The ICRA Mutual Funds Awards 2008, tomorrow at 4 p.m. on NDTV Profit.
Some little ones have more growth potential than others. Presenting HSBC Small Cap Fund. NFO closes 3rd March 2008. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Please read the offer documents carefully before investing.
My heart is beating.
Imagine a battery that loves your car as much as you do. Excite loves cars.
नेशनल इंश्योरेंस हमारे करीब 1000 कंप्यूटराइज्ड ऑफिसेज के द्वारा 101 साल से देश की सेवा में नेशनल इंश्योरेंस सुरक्षा का वादा
हाँ भाई फेंको बता लेटेस्ट क्या फेंक रहा है
अरे यार फेंक नहीं रहा हूँ बता रहा हूँ टाटा स्काई अब सिर्फ 1500 रुपए में
तू फेंक दो बैग मैं लपेट रहा हूँ
ये नहीं मानेगा कसम से चल गीता भाभी की कसम 1500 में गीता भाभी हा? हा?
टाटा स्काई 1500 में नहीं सिर्फ 1499 रुपए में कसम से टाटा स्काई सैटेलाइट टीवी सर्विस इसको लगा डाला तो लाइफ चिंगा लाला
रिटायरमेंट के बाद दुनिया देखेंगे प्लान व्हाटएवर योर प्लान्स भारती एक्सा लाइफ इंश्योरेंस विल हेल्प ब्रिंग देम टू लाइफ भारती एक्सा लाइफ इंश्योरेंस बी लाइफ कॉन्फिडेंट
Enjoy 5 times the impact of sound on Lenovo Y510 with powerful 4.1 Dolby speakers. Lenovo.
Why settle for just one when you can get both? Invest in Reliance Equity Link Saving Fund Series 1 and enjoy the double benefits of tax saving and growth potential. NFO closes 17th March 2008. Brought to you by Reliance Mutual Fund.
Reliance Anil Dhirubhai Ambani Group. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Please read the offer document carefully before investing.
Finolex का अनोखा SWR PVC pipes और fittings खास यूनि स्टेबलाइज्ड है इसे आप रिंग जॉइंटिंग या सॉल्वेंट सीमेंट जॉइंटिंग से भी जोड़ सकते हैं ये चले सालों साल पक्का वादा Finolex का
tricky race, very hard to face. Kaam itna ki na milti hai space. Wealth ki search mein sabse aage. Health soye aur success jaage. Aur jab aap karte ho finance ki arranging, ki times they are to changing.
Often in a race to gain wealth, we lose our health. Reliance Life Insurance brings to you first of its kind unit-linked insurance plan that increases your wealth and provides health insurance too. Reliance Wealth Plus Health Plan. Wealth be, health be.
Reliance Anil Dhirubhai Ambani Group.
Here we go. We're going to start the next round, this time with IIFT. Here's the round on your screens. The thesis for which product was submitted by Ram Chandra Sharma in 1971. And this thesis, to give you a clue, was submitted from Ram Chandra Sharma in Rajasthan. Give me the product. IIFT, are you trying? Okay, not trying. IIM Bangalore. Oh, quick.
The Jaipur Foot.
The Jaipur Foot was created by Ram Chandra Sharma. Brilliant. Excellent answer. Superb. It's the Jaipur Foot. Very, very good answer. The next one is for IIM Bangalore. Try this. IIM Bangalore, what kind of a person is a screenager? This is Consumer Insights. What kind of a person is a screenager? I know this looks odd.
Okay, it's a person who comes in an advertisement and grows with the, as in his age grows with the age of the advertisement. For example, like the Amul Moped.
I got it. That's not the answer. That's not a screenager. IIM.
A teenager who spends most of his time in front of the TV screen.
A teenager who spends most of his time or her time in front of a television screen is a screenager. Why not? Absolutely. 10 points. Here we go to number 3. It's for IIM Calcutta. IIM, we use the term in fashion, a bandana, right? A bandana. Has it ever occurred to you why a bandana is called a bandana? Give me the language of origin. If you give me the language of origin and something like that. Okay, IIM Calcutta, are you trying? You're not trying. IIT Mumbai.
Portuguese.
Yes. Hi.
The language of origin is Portuguese.
The language is Portuguese, so I'll put you out of your misery. No. IIT Bombay.
Okay, it's a Spanish term. It's
refers Spanish! It refers, I don't know Spanish yet. Pass you. IMT.
At least the meaning, as in like...
Oh, the meaning.
As in like, refers to a...
See, if it's a Spanish thing, and it doesn't link up to how a bandana is called a bandana. Okay, so IMT. Okay.
Okay, firstly, the bandage used to tie it, that's why it's known as bandana.
No.
It comes from the Hindi bandhana.
I said, listen, let's go to the Lucknows, the Benarases, and the Ludhianas and look for answers. That is brilliant. It comes from the Hindi bandhana. The first facility, this kind of facility, was awarded in 1728 to a merchant named William Hogg by the Royal Bank of Scotland. Okay, not as good as city, but will do. The first of what kind of facility was awarded in 1728 to a merchant named William Hogg? This is an answer which is a 9-letter answer. The question is for IIT. I think it's for IIT.
Yes. Is it overdraft?
Overdraft is 9 letters? In fact, it is. And that's the right answer. Well done. Well done. Lego Serious Play. Lego Serious Play is the first ever Lego product targeted specifically to which TG, to which target group? Okay. IMT.
I suppose adults.
I said target group, you said adults. That's absolutely right. That's all I was looking for. Okay, adults is absolutely, that's a good answer. 10 points. Here's the last round. Here we go, coming up on the screen. Okay. Checkmate. All right. On the buzzer, plus 10 when you're right, minus 10 when you're wrong. What was developed and built by Luther George Simjian and installed in 1939 in the Citibank of New York, but removed after 6 months due to the lack of customer acceptance? They've gone for it, IMT, for 10.
ATM machine.
The automatic teller machine is not the wrong answer. That's very good. It takes about 150,000 flowers and over 400 hours of labor to produce a single kilogram of which spice? They've gone again, IMT.
Saffron.
Saffron, you got 10 for your first effort. 10 again, IMT. David Ogilvy said, or rather wrote, only blank is 1/4 moisturizing cream. Go for it. IMT, 3 in a row.
Dove.
Only Dove. Wonderful. In which, you know, one of your dreams would be to work on Wall Street, I think. So, what is the New York subway, metro, train stop for Wall Street? Who's gone? IIT.
Grand Central.
Minus 10 for IIT Bombay. The only reason I asked the question, because the stop for Wall Street is known as Wall Street. Now, last one is a 5-letter answer to the teams. The usual composition of which beverage, this is according to the National Research Development Corporation, the beverage composition is fat 3%, solid non-fat 6 to 7%, sugar 10%, acidity value 0.6 to 0.7%. 5-letter answer. Try. They've gone.
Lassi.
Lassi. We've ended with a crackling answer from IMT. Lassi is the brilliant answer. With that, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of the Economic Times City Grandmasters. We're going to have Rishi back here to handle the prize distribution. I think the teams have really worked hard. Well, that was wonderful. I deliberately kept the Lassi question to the end because I didn't go to B school, but there's lots to learn in the B schools, I'm sure. But the one humble message I have to the B school is keep Peter Drucker, keep David Ogilvy, but let's always end on the note of Lassi. Thank you and good evening.
Absolutely scintillating stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it, the brave gladiators of the first ever ET City Grandmasters. Well, it's a historic moment, and to share in this piece of history, I'd like to call upon the stage our patrons. Mr. Ian Gore, Head Human Resources for Cities India Cluster. Mr. Bhaskar Das, Executive President, Times of India Group. Mr. Harish Kohli, Chief Sales Officer, Acer India, is also here with us. Mr. S. Nagarajan, Senior Director and Sales Organization Leader, India, Philips Consumer Lifestyle. Thank you for being with us. Now, the prizes. Runners-up for this evening, some superb quizzing, so close yet so far. But then someone has to come up trumps, and someone has to be runners-up, right? The team from IMT Ghaziabad, Harkirat and Siddharth. To do the honors as always, Mr. Bhaskar Das and Mr. Ian Gore, once again, thanks for all the hard work giving away these prizes. And finally, the moment is here. For the first time in management history, the winners of the first ever ET City Grandmasters All India Championship, India's first National B School Challenge, are the team from IIM Calcutta, Arnav and Vijay.
I think the ET City Grandmasters quiz has come to a fantastic conclusion. We had a lot of zonal finals, we're over a couple of hundred people who applied to come into this competition. To see it to come to this combination has been fantastic.
Though this is the first year for ET City Grandmasters, I never realized that this is the first attempt of an organization to execute a program. I think it's a great success for the first year.
Budget 2008 be about economics or electionomics?
Good economics always makes good electionomics. It's unlikely that you do anything to upset any of the allies when you have to right now start working towards the next election.
This is one golden opportunity. Why should Chidambaram let it pass?
The next elections will also be fought on the plank of EMIs.
I just wouldn't agree.
Government has declared tax benefits on SEZ zones. From where is this gap is going to be filled?
Certain proportion of the agriculture is with larger debt.
I would not quite call it that.
I think the idea is to remove all the supply side constraints.
The financial sector has really not delivered.
Why is it that we are continuously looking at the government to say they are not doing this right, they are not doing this right?
Some little ones have more growth potential than others. Presenting HSBC Small Cap Fund. NFO closes 3rd March 2008. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Please read the offer documents carefully before investing.
घर में अंडरग्राउंड आरसीसी टैंक लगा हो तो कोई पकड़े न पकड़े बीमारियां जरूर पकड़ लेती हैं, क्योंकि आरसीसी टैंक हो जाता है जल्दी क्रैक, यानी बाहर की सारी गंदगी अंदर। इसलिए सिंटेक्स अंडरग्राउंड वाटर टैंक, पानी रखे सेफ और आपको भी। सिंटेक्स अंडरग्राउंड वाटर टैंक, वन टाइम कैश लाइफ टाइम ऐश।
I have always wanted to open one bookshop. Retire होते ही खोलूंगा।
Yeah!
Cricket books भी रखूंगा।
कब? कब करोगे ये सब? जब केक पे 60 कैंडल्स होंगी। आज ही इन्वेस्ट कीजिए अबीबा के रिटायरमेंट प्लान्स में, ताकि आपको अपने दिल की सुनने के लिए 60 का इंतजार ना करना पड़े।
अबीबा लाइफ इंश्योरेंस, कल पर कंट्रोल।
My heart is beating.
Imagine a battery that loves your car as much as you do. Exide loves cars.
People are the same. That's why we at HSBC offer different banking solutions. HSBC, the world's local bank.
Kick me up, kick hai din kaas. Jeete hai to bas jeete hai janab. Kick me up, kick hai din kaas.
Jab man mein shanti ho, to zindagi mein alag hi maza hai. MetLife mein hum ye baat samajhte hain. Aur hamara har insurance plan आपके परिवार को रखता है सुरक्षित और भविष्य को सुनिश्चित। MetLife, मन की शांति गारंटी।
Some technologies are still inaccessible and some accessible enough to change lives. The common rail diesel technology is now common. IndyCar Dicor.
Allianz offers financial solutions for life's important moments. Maybe it's the moment you plan your future together. When you want your investments to work as hard as you do. When you feel confident because your business risks are covered. Since 1890, we've supported millions of people through life's moments. Whatever your moment, Allianz gives you the confidence you need. Financial solutions from A to Z. Allianz. In India, as Bajaj Allianz.
This child needs a heart surgery costing 3 lakh rupees. Over 20,000 heart operations successfully performed. Not a rupee charged. Celebrating the golden age of Sri Satya Sai.
Tax bachana itna hi saral. Birla Sun Life Saral Jeevan Plan. Invest today and save tax up to rupees 33,900. No medical tests, take immediate cover. SMS save tax to 56767.
The Economic Times City Grandmasters.
This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Profit.
Thank you.
are off again on a new journey on budget from ground zero. But this time we are traveling just across Delhi's border to one of its suburbs, Gurgaon. Full of glass and chrome buildings is the new mecca for many high-tech companies. Gurgaon is not only powering Delhi's neighboring state Haryana's growth, but is also the workplace for many a Delhiwala. Ranbaxy, one of India's biggest pharmaceutical majors, has set up its research facilities here. We land up at one such facility to meet up with Malvinder Singh, Ranbaxy's young CEO, to find out what the pharmaceutical industry wants out of this year's budget.
Hi Malvinder, a very good morning to you.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks Malvinder. It seems that this is the facility where all the high-tech research for Ranbaxy gets done.
Ranbaxy, like many of the top pharma companies in India, spends about 8 to 9% of its annual revenue on research, almost $100 million a year. And Malvinder is hoping that the government continues as well as expands the tax breaks given for research to companies like his.
I think for pharmaceuticals, there are really two key things that we're looking at. One is in terms of Section 35(2)(ab), which the finance minister had very kindly extended last year for a five-year period.
What would that be?
From 2007 till 2012, where, you know, whatever research and development that you do here, you get a 150% weighted deduction.
Okay.
What we as an industry have been talking to him is, look, you know, the scope of activities that are covered under this are quite restrictive, and they are really limited to the activities that happen within R&D inside the company.
Okay.
But today there are a lot of activities that you know, you tend to outsource either from companies in India, or you do clinical trials by third parties in India or internationally. So all of those activities don't get covered.
Okay.
In that 150% weighted deduction. So you get a regular expense deduction, but it's not 150%.
Okay.
So today, in the environment in which we are dealing and the kind of research and development activities that we are doing globally and in India with third-party organizations, I think we need to broaden that net to encompass those and to really broaden the definition so we can truly get a 150% weighted deduction on all the activities that we are doing. And I truly believe India can be that hub for the global pharma industry on NCEs like it has been in generics.
Very true. Malvinder, now of course, you know, there's another exemption on R&D, which is the income tax exemption. I want you to speak about that as well, but we'll talk about that once we go to your lab. I just want to see where all this research is done and how is it done.
Certainly.
The Indian pharma industry is today worth about $8 billion, growing at a rate of 17% annually. And breakthrough in branded and generics market and in off-patent drugs abroad means that the growth rate may continue for some time.
Okay, here we, before we walk into the lab, you'll have to wear a coat.
Okay.
Both of us.
Okay.
Exports of pharma products has reached almost $4.5 billion. To spur R&D, pharma companies doing just research were also entitled to income tax exemption, a provision which ended last year, with many pharma majors looking to hive off their R&D arms into separate entities. Malvinder hopes the government brings back the exemption in this year's budget.